Episode, you'll recall Crusader Rabbit and Rags the Tiger encountered quite a little opposition to their plan for lifting the Texas ban on jackrabbits. But perhaps there was still hope if they could only reach the Rabbit and Hare Removal Commission, the one responsible for the whole affair.
If we can convince him, our troubles are over.
And so, once more, disguising themselves as a thoroughbred horse, an animal sacred to the heart of every Texan, they set out for Austin, the capital. Ah, yes, Austin, with its tall men on tiny cars. It was here in the Bungle Building that the state conducted its animal affairs. Somewhere up there at that very moment, the commissioner was carrying on his campaign to rid the state of every last rabbit. Unaware that a rabbit and a tiger, or rather a noble horse, was about to challenge his entire program. Making their way to the 17th floor, our friends started down the long corridor of wildlife departments.
Let's see, marine department, sea lions, sea horses, and seesaws?
No.
Stork department?
Yeah, no.
Skunk department?
No, thanks.
Rabbit and hair removal department. Ah, at last.
But it wasn't quite that easy. Once inside, they were confronted by the chief secretary, who said...
Ah, what is it?
We're a horse.
Oh, I just love horses.
Well, I like secretaries, too.
All right, you guys, break it up. Who said that? We want to see the commissioner.
I guess my voice is changing.
A purple horse. Oh, well. Gee, there's a horse of a different color out here to see you. He'll be just a few minutes.
But the minutes lapsed into hours, and still our boys waited and waited. Unfortunately, the scenery wasn't conducive to relaxation. Not as far as Rags was concerned, anyway, and it wouldn't have helped his nerves one bit had he known his adversary beyond that door. For the commissioner was none other than the world-renowned big game hunter, Frank Sawbuck, in person. Oh, yes, indeed. There had been a time when Sawbuck could stop a charging rhino with a well-placed shot from nothing more than his trusty beam shooter. He was the toast of all Africa. But alas, then it happened. Frank began to lose his 20/20 vision. He was unaware of just how much his sight had slipped until one day when he was out hunting. Then, in the path of a charging bull elephant, he took his stance and calmly reached for his can of beans. Suddenly, he realized the trick his eyes had played on him. He had brought along bean soup instead of beans. And so, Sawbuck was demoted from the big game department all the way down to the rabbit and hare removal department, where we now find him pondering his fate.
Rabbits, hares, rabbits, I hate them all.
Why should Sawbuck feel this way? What will happen when he meets Crusader? Episode 11, entitled Torn Asunder, will tell us all.